So after a two-year investigation which polarized the nation and paralyzed the Trump presidency, Trump-Russia collusion has been fully and finally debunked. Or has it? One of Trump's leading tormentors, Congressman Eric Swalwell, on both the Judicial and Intelligence Committees, was sure there was collusion before the Mueller report came out, and he, along with many of his leftist colleagues, still aren't ready to move on. After an investigation which incorporated 2,800 subpoenas, 500 interviews, and some $30 million, give or take, listen to what Swalwell said on CNN before and then after the report.
I've seen plenty of evidence of collusion. We have very good circumstantial evidence that the Trump team, the family, the businesses were eager to work and were working with the Russians while the Russians were helping them. And I think in the court of law, that's enough.
Just because you are criminally a non-colluder doesn't mean that we don't want to know what evidence Bob Mueller found about efforts you and your team and your family and your business took to work with the Russians.
As Democrats decide just how far to push with more and more investigations of Trump following this watershed moment, the leftist elite media is now being held to account for the endless attention and alarmism they indulged in. And when Trump's lawyer Rudy Giuliani went on CNN with Chris Cuomo, he laid bare first the politically active investigators appointed by Mueller and then the media's collusion delusion.
He's got a staff of at least eight people who were rabid partisan Democrats. Never should have been on that staff. One of them was the counsel to the Clinton Foundation. Suppose I was investigating Hillary Clinton with the counsel to the Trump Foundation. He had a lead investigator who is all over the text saying he hated Trump. That's disgraceful. You guys
yes.
on this network
what have, I done?
Have tortured this man for 2 years with collusion, and nobody's apologized.
First of all, there,
so before we talk about obstruction,
there was
apologize for the overreaction of collusion.
Not a chance.
Well, of course you're not.
Not a chance.
Of course you're not, because
you
you're not being fair.
No, please. You know better than that or you wouldn't
no,
be
No, I
here.
Don't know better. Here. I am outraged by the behavior of these networks.
Okay.
Collusion, 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 collusion,
first
collusion.
Of all,
the respected liberal investigative journalist Glenn Greenwald, co-founder of The Intercept, said on the Democracy Now! Podcast that the media's performance in the collusion delusion was disgraceful.
This is the saddest media spectacle I've ever seen since I began practicing journalism in 2005. And what makes it even sadder is to watch all of the people who vested their journalistic credibility into what proved to be a complete and total fraud and scam continue to try and cling to some vestige of credibility by continuing to spin conspiracy theories that are even more reckless and more unhinged than the ones to which we've been subjected for 3 years. The great journalist and writer Matt Taibbi wrote in an article over the weekend, and I agree with him completely, that as humiliating as the media debacle was leading up to the Iraq war, what they did over the last 3 years in the Trump-Russia story makes all of that look like a pimple. It's ratcheted up tensions between the two most dangerous nuclear-armed powers in the world, Russia and the United States, that the Bulletin of Atomic Scientists says has brought us to 2 minutes before midnight on their doomsday clock. So it's also been extremely dangerous in ways that we don't yet know.
But if you thought the Mueller report is the end of the left's single-minded attempts to overthrow the results of the 2016 election by whatever means avail themselves, think again. At least six different committees, maybe as many as nine, are planning to investigate President Trump. But when Trump went on Fox News for his first interview after the investigation was over, he made it clear that he is now planning to publicly release the documents like the FISA warrant based on the discredited Trump-Russia dossier that formed the very basis for the investigations of Trump both before and after the election.
I have plans to declassify and release. I have plans to absolutely release, but I have some very talented people working for me, lawyers, and they really didn't want me to do it early on. One of the reasons that my lawyers didn't want me to do it is they said, if I do it, they'll call it a form of obstruction. So they'll say, oh, you released these documents. So we would make all of this information transparent. You know, in politics, you always hear transparency. We'd make it transparent, and then they'd call it obstruction, knowing the people we're dealing with. So, frankly, I thought it would be better if we held it to the end. No, but at the right time, we will be absolutely releasing.
So if Democrats think they can continue to advance scurrilous charges against Trump, the president will fight back with the fresh ammunition of his innocence on the charges of collusion and the obvious culpability of the Obama Justice Department in ginning this whole thing up.